Hello students, today we will study about catalysis. Catalysts, we all know that catalysts, they are used to speed up the chemical reaction. But here we'll study about the negative catalysis also. Now see, a substance which alters the rate of a chemical reaction, which changes the rate of a chemical reaction without being used up in a reaction. We all know that when the reaction is over, the catalyst, it is obtained as such, in that original state only. And the phenomenon, it is termed as catalysis. Okay. So, catalyst, it is the substance which alters the rate of a chemical reaction. Now, positive and negative catalysis. Positive is the catalyst which increases the rate of reaction. They are called positive catalyst. And the process, it is called positive catalysis. Like when nitrogen and hydrogen, they are taken and they are mixed with platinum, it enhances the rate of a chemical reaction and it make the reaction faster and ammonia is formed. In the same way, sulfur dioxide and oxygen, when they are used, V2O5 vanadium pentoxide, it acts as a catalyst, positive catalyst, it enhances the rate of a chemical reaction and SO3 is formed. Now, negative catalysis is also there, the catalyst which decreases the rate of a reaction. They are termed as a negative catalyst and the process is called negative catalysis. Like deposition of hydrogen peroxide gets retarded when some glycerin is added to it. When glycerin is added, the decomposition of hydrogen peroxide, it slows down, it gets retarded. So, glycerin here, it is acting as a negative catalyst. Now, promoters and poisons. Here in the Haber's process, we have studied about the promoters and promoters we have studied. Yes. So, the substances which increases the activity of a catalyst which we are using, and the substance which enhances the property or the activity of this catalyst, they are called promoters. And whereas the substances which reduces the activity of this catalyst, they reduces the activity of a catalyst, they are called poisons. Okay. Now, after that, we'll study about the types of catalysis. There are two types of catalysis. The first one is homogeneous catalysis. Homogeneous means there is uniformity, there is a single phase, and such catalysis is called homogeneous, means the reactants and the catalyst taken, they all will be in the same physical state. They will all in a single phase. Like here, if you see, sulfur dioxide gas is there, oxygen gas is there, NO gas is there, and it is acting as a catalyst. It enhances this reaction and SO3 gas will be formed. Now, if you are talking about heterogeneous catalysis, here when the catalyst does not mix up homogeneously with the reactant and forms a separate phase, it forms a separate phase. Generally, like gases are here and solid catalyst is added. Here mainly the process of adsorption takes place. Like this is the solid catalyst, and on the surface of this catalyst, these gases get adsorbed and it will make the reaction faster. It will happen like that. So there are the steps which are involved in the heterogeneous catalysis. As it is a chemisorption, adsorption, chemical adsorption, where these substances, they will react chemically on the surface of this catalyst. So adsorption process is there and it's a chemisorption. Chemisorption of reactants on the surface of what? Surface of a catalyst. Suppose this is a catalyst and two reactants are there, A and B. They will get adsorbed on the surface of the catalyst, like A here and B here. Then occurrence of a chemical reaction at the catalyst surface. On the surface of this catalyst, A and B will combine with each other. This is the second step where they will combine with each other. Now in the third step, see what will happen. Desorption of the products. Desorption means here they will combine together to form the product, and this product, it will desorb itself from the surface of a catalyst. So these are the three steps which will be involved there in the heterogeneous catalysis. Now, important features of a solid catalyst. If the catalyst is solid, what are its important features? The first one is the activity. It is the ability of a catalyst to accelerate chemical reactions. Like if platinum, it increases the rate of a reaction between hydrogen and oxygen. It can increase to such an extent that the reaction, it can be an explosive violence. So it is the ability, activity is the ability of a catalyst to accelerate the rate of a reaction. Now selectivity means it is the ability of a catalyst to direct a chemical reaction to yield a particular product. Means it depends on the catalyst that what will be the products. It depends upon the catalyst. Like here we have taken ethanol. When copper is acting as a catalyst at 623 Kelvin, then the product was this ethanol. This is hydrogenation reaction. Hydrogen is removed, dehydrogenation reaction. Hydrogen is removed from here. But when alumina was taken at the same temperature, we were getting an unsaturated hydrocarbon along with the formation of water, means dehydration was there. So there is a selectivity, means particular type of catalyst we use to get particular products. It depends upon the type of catalyst taken. Okay, so these are the activity, two properties or two features of the solid catalyst. The first one is activity and the second one is selectivity. Now enzyme catalysis. Enzyme, obviously it will take in our body or the body of a living organism. See, without enzymes, one meal which will take, it will take almost 50 years for the process of digestion, complete digestion, if no enzymes will be there in our body. It means enzymes, they are important class of globular protein, and these act as a biocatalyst. They catalyze the chemical reactions taking place or the biological reactions taking place in our body or in the body of the living systems. Okay, so these are enzymes, they act as a catalyst. Prosthetic group, some enzymes, they are associated with some non-protein components, and that non-protein component, it might be some metal ion or like that. That component, it is called prosthetic group. If this prosthetic group is a metal ion, then that is called cofactor, and if that prosthetic group is it is some small organic molecule, then it is called coenzyme. Okay, apoenzyme, the protein part of those enzymes which are derived from vitamins. If protein part of the enzyme, it is derived from vitamins like thiamine and riboflavin, it is called apoenzyme. Now, characteristic of enzyme catalysis, specificity. Enzymes are highly specific. It is not like that, that to digest protein, if any enzyme is required, it can digest vitamins also. It is not like that. The enzymes are very specific in their nature or in their action. Like urea, hydrolysis of urea is there. Urease is used to, and we'll get ammonia and carbon dioxide. That same urease, it cannot be used to hydrolyze and methyl urea. No reaction will take place then. It means the enzymes are highly specific in their actions. And this specificity, it is due to the shape and the size of the cavity on the substrate as well as the shape and size of the enzyme. Okay, this is because of that shape and size of the cavity and the enzyme. Now, catalytic efficiency. Catalyst can speed up the reactions up to 10 million times. It is called catalytic efficiency. Very small quantity is sufficient to catalyze a reaction. It is not like if any reaction has to take place, then we have to take very much amount of enzyme in that. It is not like that. The enzyme renin, it can coagulate over a million time of its own weight of milk protein. Million times of its own weight, it can easily coagulate that milk protein. Now, optimum temperature and pH. Yes, optimum temperature, like our body temperature is 37 degrees Celsius. So that optimum temperature and pH around 5, it is required for the proper functioning of enzymes. Enzymes inhibitors, in the presence of the substance, enzyme lose their activity and they are called enzymes inhibitors. Now see the mechanism of enzyme catalysis. It is a lock and key mechanism and it was given by Fischer. See, this is enzyme E. It will act on a substrate. It will form an enzyme substrate complex. This enzyme substrate complex will give the product, that is enzyme product, and this enzyme product from this enzyme will be separated and the product will be separated from it. So this is how the enzyme catalysis it takes place. Now we'll study about the shape selective catalysis by zeolites. Zeolites are shape selective. See, this is the general formula for zeolites, where M represents a metal ion and it can have any valency N. Zeolites, they are microporous aluminosilicates, and these are used in petrochemical industries. Okay, the most important feature of the zeolite is shape selectivity. Shape selectivity means particular shape will be there in the substrate, and then only the process of catalysis can take place. The reaction taking place in zeolites, they depend upon the size of the reactant and product molecules as compared to the size of the cages or pores of the zeolites. So the cages or the pores which are present there on the zeolite and the size of the reactants and the products formed, it depends on that. That's why it is called shape selective catalysis. This is a formula for one of the zeolite, that is Na56, AlO256, SiO2-136.25H2. So this was all about catalysis. Thank you.